Yo, what is going on, COD Familia? It is your boy BN, aka Mr. Kingdom Builder, and it is popping off here in SSS1-26. I ended up getting pinged by, oh gosh, who did I get pinged by? I have to remember now. I always got to give people their shout outs. My buddy Jess Lucas. Yes, from S97. Ended up shooting me a ping here on Discord, and we got GXS going up against LOK. This is, I believe, in Nivola. I'm a little bit scared to zoom out currently because I do not want to necessarily lose anything. Let's see if we can lower our render quality real quick. Oh, wow. I didn't realize I was up that high. Let's go to 1. That should probably be okay. There we go. Yep. A little bit smoother. Now, remember what we usually notice when we are changing render quality, which is, let me just tighten that. Fantastic. What we usually notice is it takes a minute for the adjustments to catch up. And we've been testing this a little bit so far, and I'm actually pretty pleased with it. So it's probably going to take maybe 30 seconds, 60 seconds, give or take, somewhere in there. And then hopefully, if it plays out the way it has the past couple times, we'll start seeing a lot more of the negative numbers and DPS damages, and hopefully some more names too as well. I did not realize I had it up to 1.3. That's pretty high. So, oh, you know what? I bet you it adjusted from the update. Because sometimes after updates, some of the settings might return to normal, maybe, but I know I've never had it as high as 1.3, so that's my thought. Okay, let's see what is popping here, man. Now, I want to point out, LOK, I believe, had a little bit more players than GXS did, at least it looked like visually on screen, before the engagement started here. Lots of artifacts being thrown down there, strike a light, that city shot, that time bomb, those terrifying infernos. Oh man, I think we saw a tier of Arbun being thrown down. Oh gosh, I wonder if that was a frost barrier there from Talia that just ended. Let's see here. Pushing in that Thunder Shadow. Little surround going down. You can see GXS pushing back a little bit here. I'm shocked that I'm not seeing any like DPS damages or more names, because it's not as though, I mean, again, like when we've covered SSS 1-10 or 11, where there's what it feels like there's 200 or 300 legions on the field, it doesn't look as though visually right now that there's that many, but we're still seeing a level of delay here. So who knows, right? Maybe it could have been from that brief patch that we ended up seeing, even though I don't really think that might have affected. Yeah, because see, now we're seeing our good old lag buddy friend Hector El Grande, even though I lowered my render quality. Yeah, which I'm shocked. I mean, again, you could see that the animations are fine. Or sorry, as far as the visuals, right, from the troop movements and actions are okay, but it's just a matter of us catching up with the names and then being able to see some of those DPS damages as well. Okay, a little better. A little better. So maybe it was just the restart that we needed. So it's not too bad. And now we're actually seeing, we are seeing some numbers, right? Wow, that was a lot for whatever just happened there. Okay, so we'll leave this at 1.1 and hope that maybe we get some things stabilize a bit. All right, fantastic. So GXS, LOR, this actually isn't bad. Both sides getting some replenishment. So this is one of the big things that we'll often hit at, which is just kind of spreading yourselves out a little bit more. Both groups, for the most part, are pretty bunched. LOR maybe kind of sporadically a little wider going top-down, but you know, typically you kind of want to avoid the bunching, usually, especially if you're kind of fighting at each other's like 50-yard line, so to speak, where you're kind of going top-down. Kind of, you either want to form a straight line or kind of a crescent moon, so to speak, because you want to be able to maximize kind of staying at max range, and then also when you're engaging or disengaging, depending if your infantry is pushing or if you're getting pushed, you just have a little bit more flexibility in that regard. Ooh, that was a nice Shadow Games being thrown down. That Vicious, with the up to 3 arrows being thrown, that Burst Strike, Terrifying Inferno. Ooh, that Thunder Shadow and Tingling Flames. Nice, getting some of those surrounds out. Oh, this is good. There's just really some solid, good old-fashioned, we're just going at it for our PvP. And this is what I'm talking about. Like, so right here where you're seeing a lot of clumping, very similar clumping here too as well, right? Spreading out is just, again, it allows you to take less AoE damage and then inflict, hopefully, more AoE damage on your opponents, right? That's kind of the idea behind it. but man, I mean, they're both going at it and happened for a minute, so this isn't bad. And this is, I probably should have shown this off in the beginning, but this is SSS. I know we said 26, but this is 95, 96, 97, and 98 here. A divine mercy for that Tears of Arbin, getting a nice little heal there. Ooh, that royal punishment. Oh man, I wish we could see all of the negatives. That's the one thing we're not seeing a lot right now is the purples. As far as for any of the artifact damage that's being dealt. So it still seems like we're dealing with a little bit. Ooh, another royal punishment being thrown down there. That Thunder Shadow. Going down, Time Bomb being thrown down there on Brad, we'll say Brad. GX is still consolidated. It looks like, I mean, LOR is doing an okay job in some of these pockets that we're seeing with, again, kind of spreading out. Typically, if you have, oh, there we go. We finally saw a negative purple, or maybe I'm just noticing it now. That Thunder Shadow, there we go. So a little bit more. Finally, we're seeing a bit more. Another one over there. There is the, looks like maybe that was the Entangling Flames. Hitting their quick builds to get some speed building going down here. What's this? Is this tower? It's like an hour. Yes, probably going to put a few more. That Burst Strike getting thrown down there right on Kuro for a little bit of damage. There we go. Another Divine Mercy getting a little bit of heal. Yeah, I mean, I would say decently placed on this one, right? Just because usually when you're going to throw heal artifacts down, you just want to make sure that you're not placing it too far forward, because if you're getting pushed, then you're just not going to get the max heal off. But you don't necessarily want to place it too far back where it's going to take you a long time to re-engage in the fight. So I thought that was actually well placed based on kind of where the fight was going. Oh gosh, dude, big negatives that are coming down. And this is what we're talking about, where you're seeing the clumping here. You can see this from like these 3-4 legions that are right here, where you're seeing just multiple negative red DPS damage that's being done, where you're just taking a lot of that unnecessary AoE damage, really for kind of no reason. And this is one of the things that we often talk about, which is why Call of Dragons, in my opinion, is just a higher quality game when it comes to the standard level of PvP. And the skill of PvP, and this is specifically talking about having good positioning and micromanaging your troops, or your legions, we should say, to where you're able to spread them out and do those things in real time to where you're not taking a lot. Because you have to, I mean, keep in mind, right? Most of the players here are probably just double-clicking or doing something else to select all their troops, and they're just moving all their troops in kind of general directions for the most part. It can be difficult when a fight is happening in real time to be thinking about these things, where you need to constantly be always having good positioning, spreading out, not overextending yourself. If you're going to have infantry push, you're having others push with you, you're focus firing particular units. Usually, if you're not in a voice call and you have someone who's making these types of commands or issuing these actions, then the next best thing really is, and this is kind of bare minimum, I shouldn't say next best thing, but the bare minimum really is what people, is what we should be seeing alliances doing, is informing their players ahead of time. So you're taking time to write a mail, you're issuing instructions, you're saying, hey, we're going to use these reactions, or these are the people that are going to be on, or they're, when they're on the field, right, try and listen to them, and just as examples, right? Oh man, so good, dude. Awesome, man. They're still going at it, though. GXS, I think, still getting some replenishment. Let's see here. Okay, a little bit here and there. Yeah, we can see here LOR definitely getting a little bit more than GXS currently when we're just kind of looking at those replenishment lines. Ooh, that was a nice Shadow Games that got thrown down. What was that? Multiple negative 10k plus damage. That was pretty good. And you can see even on the field, right? What are we seeing a lot usage-wise, right? You're seeing a lot of Lilias. You got some Velns. You got some Theas. And then next up, right, you're going to kind of have your marksmen. So the idea is, and I'll just kind of give you an example, if we zoom out a bit, you can kind of see mages far back, archers kind of mid, and then you have your front line and or cav, sorry, your infantry, right, which is shields. And that's kind of how if you're thinking about it, you really kind of want to set it up, right? You kind of always want to be trying to fight at max distance. Now, obviously the units that are this far back aren't doing any attacking right now. So again, you're not necessarily really maximizing your efficiency. This is why we typically often talk about spreading out, because if you're spreading out, you're giving up to, if not hopefully, all of your legions that are out on the field, the opportunity to do the attacking, right? Where an example here is if you see all of these units that are actively attacking these frontline units, or this Madeline Nika here from Toxie, and then you're noticing that some of the other units, for a moment, right? And obviously it's different now, but 5 or 10 seconds ago, you didn't see a lot of the avatars here being active, which means that they're engaged, right? In either attacking or defending if they are being attacked in that regard. So like, those are things. Ooh, wow, that was a really good one. Oh man, that royal punishment that just got thrown down. That was sick. There. Love it. Oh man, another divine mercy getting thrown down. Nice heals here too as well. You see the plus greens that are getting thrown down, right? That's going to be 4 procs every 2 seconds for 8 seconds. Another shadow games. Nice time bomb being thrown down too as well. That terrifying inferno getting thrown. Another time bomb. There's the burst strike getting thrown down there, right there. You saw that hitting up to 2 people there for the negative purple. Oh, man. Yeah, I mean, again, LOR is pushing. Right now. And building two as well. Also doing a little bit of spread here where, okay, looks like easy throwing some stuff out here for some of the other GXS players. I wonder if they were going to see, usually, most of the time, outside of the main fight, you're typically going to see, like, calved roaming, which is usually kind of good strategy, right? You're trying to kind of, you're either going and trying to break up supply lines or reinforcement lines from roads, or you're kind of flanking off to the side and kind of picking off the stragglers, right? That typically is ideal strategy and tactics when you're trying to run cav, even to another extent, kind of Celestials as well. But man, this has actually been great. Always a big fan. Another Shadow Games getting thrown down there. Oh, that's Sword Oath, excuse me. Oh, you see LOR there for Strike, right? Trying to go back in there with the Emrys, doing some tile hopping there. Getting in a little behind. Looks like was able to do some damage too as well. And that's the big thing, right? Obviously, you know, you don't necessarily want to overextend and kind of take unnecessary damage. But if you're able to go and engage on specific fights or specific legions, right, that are potentially going to be in your favor, you know, it's okay to do that, especially if the ratio numbers are more on your side, right, compared to the other one. Yeah, no, not bad though, man. Always happy to come and watch some PvP. So I definitely appreciate the ping, no matter what, man. Always gotta love it. Yeah, hopefully you guys might be. You have to let me know if you're able to hear some of the actual sound effects for the fights that are happening on. If not, I'm gonna have to take a look into that one. So to see maybe why it's not playing, but it is for some reason on, from what I can actually see. All right. Let me see. We're coming up to about 18 minutes here that I got. Probably going to have to dip off here in another minute. But we're going to watch a little bit more to see what else. This is going to be a little shorter. I know usually I'm trying to record for about 20 to 30 minutes. Just because I think that's a good amount of time for being able to see any potential back and forths as well. Again, even though I may not always be able to do those things. Wow. Oh, wow. Now we actually have LOK. I thought it was just LOR. So wow, so LOK ended up joining too as well. See, so much stuff was going on. I couldn't even see all the names going up against GXS. I wonder, can we see rankings yet for power? Oh, I can't. Okay, so I can't see power rankings, but what I can do is we can look at this. So GXS is at 2.7 billion. And then we had LOR, who's at 2.9, almost 3 billion. And then there was also LOK. There was LOV. I don't know where LOK. Here we go. LOK is at 1.7, almost 1.8 billion. So a little bit of a 2v1 here. Favor for power, of course, going on that LOK, LOR side. I wonder if there's anyone here that's on the GXS side. Maybe they're just not out right now. TNT, okay. But TNT wasn't there. And then we have LOR and LOK. Oh, I see. So they're pushed pretty heavy. So they came all the way from Sephrostia into Nivola. And now they're pushing. Elo or Lost is up here, but doesn't look like there's any action going up north. So, okay. So it looks like really they're just trying to kind of push them back to their pass. So you got the LOK, actually pushing LOK out all the way to where they maybe would have to go back because they don't have anything connecting right now. Okay, interesting. Wow, gotta love it, man. Okay, awesome stuff. All right, I'm going to try and come back if I can. This was actually pretty cool. Again, I always love watching any of the big fights, especially as much as possible. For anyone that knows, right, I always love trying to show off as many kingdoms, whether that's home kingdoms or season ones, or even if it's merged kingdoms in 1+, as much PvP as we can. Always try to give as many people some love. And again, man, I really do. I always enjoy watching PvP. More so when there's a little bit less lag, which I think can probably be universally stated by everyone. But yeah, again, I don't know too much about the history here for 26. I know I have some notes on the merge group, but again, always happy to hear how things have been going. Whether you're someone who's been fighting, have you been enjoying the fights? If you want to give me some history or a little bit of a overview or summary on how things have been going, would love to hear. Right, and as always, let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. If there's any other types of PvP that you'd like to try and see me cover. And then the very last thing, which is super important I have to mention, is that if you ever want me to come and have a chance to cover your kingdom, right, you can always ping me on Discord. It's @BossNasty with an I, not a Y, all one word. And I think it's all lowercase now. But you can always add me. You can ping me. You can join the Discord. I have a channel on my Call of Dragons section, which is, or category if you want to be technical for Discord and call it that, where you guys can post, and I think it's called COD Wars hyphen drama. And so, you know, I get people almost every day, if not every day, that will post and give me alerts, or they'll shoot me a DM. Trust me when I say you're never bugging me. I always appreciate anyone who gives me a heads up, regardless if I can make it there in that moment or not. You know, me just knowing is really half the battle, right? And then it's just a matter of, okay, well, can I find the time to go ahead and join? So that's going to do it for me. As always, right, I will catch you guys next time. Whenever we get some PvP, hopefully we can come back, especially because remember, this is just Zone 1. So hopefully we'll be able to come back and see some of the Zone 2, maybe some Zone 3 action. So awesome stuff. Gotta love it. That's going to do it for me. As always, until next time, I will catch you later.